before we will see the concept of what will be the current distributions, right? In there we will see the what will be the line current density and as well as the surface current density and as well as the volume current density, right? Now let's see the another important concept for your university examination point of view, as well as in GATE examination point of view, as well as your ESC examination point of view. So this concept will be the very very important. Okay, magnetic field intensity due to the straight filamentary conductor. In this case, what we have to take, we have to be taking the straight filamentary conductor. Here you can see I will be taking this be my straight filamentary conductor of finite length AB. Okay, suppose we assume that the conductor is along the z-axis. Okay, where my conductor has to be placed along the z-axis. Okay, so this will be the plus z-axis. So if you want to move downside, this will become your minus z-axis, right? With its upper and lower ends respect to the suspended angles alpha 1 and as well as then alpha 2. Okay, here you can see we can't take up to the infinite length. We have to be bounded ourselves towards the finite length. I will be named it as an this be my A, and suppose I will be named this be my B. Okay, and here you can see I will be taken this be my small length. This be my small length, that will be represented with D L. Right, done. Next, what I will be taken? I will be taken here my point. For example, suppose I will be taken here my point P. Okay, from point P to this current carrying element, I have to be find out my magnetic field intensity. Here at the point P, I will be choosing the two cases. First case be the inside the board or outside the board. I already explained you this concept many more times from the past two lectures. You already know, right? So if I will be taken inside the board, okay, I will be taken my magnetic field intensity, that be the inside the board. What I will be doing is I will be drawing from A to point B, I will be drawing some angle, draw a line. I will be taken this be the my angle 2. Okay, that be the alpha 2. Here also I will be draw from point B to this point P, I will be drawing another line. I will be taking this be my angle alpha, suspended angle alpha 1. Okay, and here what I will be doing is I will be taken from this point P to this straight filamentary conductor. I will be drawing perpendicular distance. That means we have to be draw the straight line like this. Okay, we have to be draw the straight line like this. It will make some angle 90 degrees like that. Okay, this be the perpendicular line. Okay, I think this be the somewhat straight like this. Okay, that this distance be the I will be taken this be the rho. And one more thing you have to be see, what I will be taken means from point P to DL, that be the small length, I will be taken this be my the distance, that be my R bar. Okay, so here I will be taken in the z-axis. I will be taken in the z-axis. So what I will be taken means here I will be considered this be my origin. This be my origin. So here this will be represented with 0, 0, 0. And here you can see I will be taken only the z-axis. Okay, that will become the here 0 comma x axis will become the 0, and similar the y axis will become the 0, and I will be choosing only the my z axis. Okay, this thing is enough. We have to dissolve our here this z axis, whatever the thing we have to be taken, this is also be said to be the conductor axis. This z axis, whatever we have to be done until now, that will be said to be the my conductor axis. Here you can see I will be choosing the two angles, one be the suspended upper suspended angle, and similarly one be the lower suspended angle, right? I will be name it as an alpha 1 as well as an alpha 2. Here I will be taking my Biot-Savart's law. What will be the formula for the Biot-Savart's law? Formula for my Biot-Savart's law, h bar is equal to, that b equal to 1 divided by 4 pi integration of l I dl bar cross r bar divided by r cube. This be my Biot-Savart's law formula, right? We already solved this formula. If you are new here, please watch that Biot-Savart's law lecture, then you will get to know how we can solve this formula. Here now first step, what we have to do is we have to be find out my differential length. What will happen here? I will be consider this be my differential length, right? Total length be the L. I will be considering this my small part, that small part that will be represented with the DL. So here this DL can be represented with the DZ bar, right? So here DL bar, that be represented with the DZ bar, unit vector be the AZ bar, right? Done. Now what will happen to the radius r bar, that will be equal to here. This radius r bar can be reached towards my point B. Okay, here we have to be encountered with the two issues. One be from the perpendicular distance, you already know that's not be an issue, but the thing be the from 0 to this point, this A, what will happen? Okay, here I will be placed my conductor of element in the z axis. I will be taken, that's be 0, 0, 0, and I will be taken my origin be the 0, 0, 0. This be the just like a straight line, right? So how you can find out this? This will become the 0 minus 0 AX bar plus 0 minus 0 AY bar plus 0 minus Z AZ bar. Right? Done. So 0 minus 0 AX bar, 0 minus 0 AY bar, 0 minus Z AZ bar. So how much I will get this be the minus Z AZ bar, right? Plus what will be my perpendicular distance? That's be in the rho direction. So this be the rho arrow bar. So plus rho arrow bar. So this will be our R bar. So this be our R bar. Now what we have to do means we have to be find out my DL cross R bar. What will happen? So DL bar cross R bar, that be equal to DL bar, that be the DZ AZ bar cross, what will be my R bar? That be the minus Z AZ bar plus rho arrow bar. So this will become the DZ AZ bar, so into rho arrow bar minus Z AZ bar. So this will be the DZ into, here you already know one more crucial thing whenever we have to be solved this type of derivation, that be the, here you can see this be our rho, here this be our 5, and here is this be our Z, right? Whenever we have to be find out the cross product, we have the two unit vectors, that be the arrow bar and as well as then a5 bar, whatever the missing product, that be the az bar, right? So here this will become my A Z bar, A Z bar. And similarly, if you have then phi Z, what will be the missing? Row missing, right? This will become your A row bar. Similarly, if you have your Z and row, what will be the missing? Phi missing, right? So this will become the A phi bar. Done. Here you can see what will happen to the A Z bar cross A row bar. How much you will get? You will get your A phi bar. That's only I will be represented here. Here you can see A Z bar cross A row bar. How much I will get? I will get my A phi bar. A phi bar. This thing. Minus Z into AZ bar cross AZ bar. So this will become my zero. Whenever you have to be multiplied the cross product with the same unit vectors, you will get your zero. So this will become your, what will be the remaining terms? So this will become your row DZ A phi bar minus zero. This will become the row DZ A phi bar. So this will become your DL bar cross R bar. So this will become your DL bar cross R bar. Now let's see what will happen if I will be taken. What will happen if I will be taken? I will be just assume that row be the cot alpha. What will happen? Sorry, I will be taken the my Z be the, I will be taken my Z be the, let's take your Z be the cot alpha. Okay, just assume it. So what will happen to the DZ? So this will become my Z is equal to rho cot alpha. So this will become my minus rho cosecant square alpha into d alpha. Right? This will be my DZ. I already get my DZ and I will be get my R bar, that be the minus Z AZ bar plus rho arrow bar. Done. Substitute all of those things. We all get all of my all of those things. Just put it those things in the electric field magnetic field intensity. So this will become the H is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi. So integration of here you can see I will be taken lower angle supplement angle with alpha 1 and upper supplement angle that be the alpha 2. So here this be the capital I into what will be my DL cross R bar. DL cross R bar that be the rho DZ A phi bar divided by what will be my rho DZ A phi bar, next divided by R cube, right? Divided by R cube. Now you already know that R cube also, that be the minus Z AZ bar plus rho arrow bar, that be the R, right? So here don't worry. So here this will become the integration of alpha 1, this be the alpha 2, I divided by 4 pi. What will be my rho? What will be my DZ? DZ be the minus rho cosecant square alpha, minus rho cosecant square alpha, D alpha into A phi bar, right? Divided by what will be my R cube? So R that be the minus z az bar plus rho arrow bar. So this be the whole to the power of whole cube. Now here you can see, so h that be equal to integration, this be the alpha 1, this be the alpha 2, minus I into rho, that will become the rho square cosecant square alpha, cosecant square alpha d alpha a phi bar divided by 4 pi into this be my, what will be my z be my minus rho minus rho. So minus rho cot alpha minus rho cot alpha plus what will be my, this will become my rho a rho bar. So here this be the cube, right? Cube, how you can write? So this be the square, square whole to the power of 3 by 2, right? So this will become the square. So this will be the minus rho square cot square alpha. So this will become your 3 by 2, right? So here this will become the h is equal to integration of alpha 1 to alpha 2 I minus I rho square cosecant square alpha d alpha. This be the a phi bar. So this be the 4 pi. So this will become the rho square. So if you want to take rho square plus cot square alpha. Right. So here how you can write? Here this be the, how you can write, this be the rho square plus z square whole to the power of 3 by 2, right? So here this will become your, this will become your rho square, rho square plus what will be your z, z be the rho, rho, that be the square means that will become the rho square cot square alpha whole to the power of 3 by 2, right? So here you can see, if you want to take the rho square common, this will become the rho square whole to the power of 3 by 2 into, so this will become the 1 plus cot square alpha whole to the power of 3 by 2. So here you can see 2 will get cancelled. 2 will get cancelled here. So here h, that will be equal to integration of alpha 1 to alpha 2. Here this be the minus I rho square cosecant square alpha d alpha a phi bar divided by 4 pi. So this be the rho cube, rho cube, rho cube. So 1 plus cot square alpha, 1 plus cot square alpha, that will be the cosecant square alpha. So this be the cosecant square alpha whole to the power of 3 by 2. So here square square will get cancelled. So here what you will get, how much you will get? So how much you will get? So h, that will be equal to integration of alpha 1 to alpha 2. So this be the minus I. So this be the rho square cosecant square alpha d alpha a phi bar divided by, this be the 4 pi rho cube cosecant cube alpha, right? Cosecant cube alpha. So here h is equal to, this be the lower limit be the alpha 1, upper limit be the alpha 2. Here you can see how many times, this be the minus I cosecant square alpha d alpha a phi bar divided by, this be the 4 pi rho. So this be the cosecant cube alpha, cosecant cube alpha. Here you can see, so h is equal to, so h is equal to, put the constants outside, I divided by 4 pi rho. So this be the alpha 1, alpha 2. So this be the cosecant square alpha d alpha a phi bar divided by cosecant cube alpha. Done. Now, so here h is equal to minus I divided by 4 pi rho. So this be the alpha 1, alpha 2, how many times? So one time, right? So this be the 1 divided by cosecant alpha d alpha into a5 bar. So how much you will get your h? H is equal to minus I divided by 4 pi rho, 1 divided by cosecant alpha, 1 divided by cosecant alpha, that be the sin alpha. Okay, 1 divided by cosecant alpha, that be the sin alpha. Alpha 1, alpha 2, so this be the sin alpha, so d alpha a pi bar. Okay, done. Now what the simple mistake we have to be do means, here r bar r cube, right? That's be the rho square plus z square, right? Unit vectors. 1 into square, that will become the 1. Right? That's the mistake we have to be doing. We have to be done. That's why I will correct that mistake. That's the remaining process is not a big issue. Right? Let's see. So here, how much h is equal to? H is equal to minus I divided by 4 pi rho, 4 pi rho here. So this will become the minus cos alpha integration. If you apply the sine integration, that will become the minus cos alpha. So lower limit be the alpha 1, upper limit be the alpha 2. This be the d alpha a phi bar. So here this will become the minus into minus, that will become the plus. So I divided by 4 pi rho. So this be the cos alpha 2 minus cos alpha 1 into a phi bar. So how much you will get? H that will be equal to I divided by 4 pi rho cos alpha 2 minus cos alpha 1 into a phi bar. Okay, here we will be consider the two cases. We will be consider the semi-infinite, and we will be taken the infinite long conductor. Okay, case one that be the semi-infinite long conductor. So what I will be do means, here you can see I will be taken this z, I will be just extended like this. I will be taken my this point P at infinite. Okay, I will try to put my point this right straight line towards the infinite. Whenever I will be put towards the infinite, that will be reached towards the zero, right? That will be reached towards the zero. Then I will be taking this be my 90 degrees. So alpha 2 that be the 0 degrees and alpha 1 that will be equal to 90 degrees. Okay, I think you will be understood. What I will be doing means, I will be taking my point P to the infinite. Whenever that straight line reaching towards the infinite, obviously that line will be going. At one point it will be reached towards the zero. Okay, that's the point I will be taken here, alpha 2, that will be equal to 0 degrees. And similarly, my alpha 1 I will be taking, that be the perpendicular, that be the 90 degrees. Okay, so here how much you will get? You will get h bar is equal to, or h is equal to I divided by 4 pi rho. So this be the cos 0 degrees minus cos 90 degrees. So this will become the I divided by 4 pi rho. So this be the 1 minus 0. So this be the a phi bar, right? A phi bar. So how much you will get? I divided by 4 pi rho a phi bar. So h, I will be considered another case. This case be the very, very important. Okay, please remember this case. case 2, that be the infinite long conductor. Infinite long conductor. So, if I will be taking my infinite long conductor, what will happen? So, here alpha 2 that will be equal to 0 degrees, and similarly alpha 1 that will be equal to the 180 degrees. Okay. Here, just to substitute that, so h that will be equal to the I divided by 4 pi rho. So, this will become the cos alpha 2 that be the 0 degrees minus cos 180 degrees, right? So, into a phi bar. So, this will become the I divided by 4 pi rho. So, this be the 1 minus of minus 1 cos 180, that will be the minus 1, right? I will be putting the minus 1 into a phi bar. A phi bar. So, this will become the I divided by 4 pi rho 2 into a phi bar. How many times? 2 times. How much answer you will get? I divided by 2 pi rho a phi bar. This be the very, very important. H is equal to I divided by 2 pi rho a phi bar. This be the very, very important. There will be a lot of gate questions they might be asked based on this formula. Okay, this derivation be the not that much of important, simple trigonometry only, but you have to be focused on the result. This result, h is equal to I divided by 2 pi rho a phi bar. Okay, and one more thing we have to be forgot, how we can write the a phi bar that will be equal to, that's be the very, very important, a phi bar that be equal to al bar cross a rho bar. So here al bar represents the length of the conductor, and here this a rho represents the that radius of the conductor. Okay, I will be taking the radius be the a rho bar. Whenever we have to be solved the questions based on the magnetostatics, we will be using this formula. A phi bar is equal to AL bar cross A rho bar. Whenever I will be get that, this H is equal to I divided by 2 pi rho, it's not an issue. Okay. I hope you like this video, magnetic field intensity due to the astride filamentary conductor. Whenever you have to be prepared for the gate examination point of view, this formula is enough, and as well as in, you must have to be remember this formula and as well as in this formula. Three formulas is enough whenever you have to be considered for the gate examination. Suppose if you are prepared for the ESC examination, you must have to be derived this derivation. Okay, I think most of the students will get confused whenever they will be derived this derivation. Don't worry. If you not getting one time, please watch my lecture 1 to 2 times, then you will get to know very well. Okay, that EMTL subject be like that only, like this much of derivations be present. You must have to be, don't worry about the derivations, but you have to be concentrate on the learning the things. Okay, learning the concept is very, very important. So, for ESC examination, the derivation must be important. Okay, so this formula here, this and that, and here this, but semi-infinite is not that much of important. There will be not so many questions be there, but this infinite long conductor, there will be a couple of questions be present. Okay, and if they will be asked in general, you have to be directly substitute this formula. H bar is equal to I divided by 4 pi rho cos alpha 2 minus cos alpha 1 into a phi bar. Okay, this be the just like in subject lectures, right? That's why I will be trying to solve this many derivations. Okay, after 1 to 2 months, we will be taking yana like whole syllabus, just like in revision. Okay, at that revision, I can't solve that much of derivation. Okay, I will be writing this magnetic field intensity due to the straight filamentary conductor. There, I will be write this diagram and I explain this diagram. and directly write this result. Okay, h bar is equal to I divided by 4 pi rho cos alpha 2 minus cos alpha 1 into a phi bar. This result and this results, and as well as this results. At that time, please don't confuse. Okay, that's why I will put this like a theory lectures, full electromagnetic subject. Okay, I hope you like this video. If you really like this video, please like my video, share my video, as well as subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you.